Hello everyone, I'm Srikar. So I'm here to present my machine learning assignment, which is classification of sports balls using different machine learning algorithms. As I'm using classification, so the main algorithms which I'm going to deal with are perceptron algorithm, decision tree, logistic regression, and neural networks along with random forest. So I have taken four different types of balls in my data set for my model to train them. So these are basketball, football, cricket ball, and rugby ball. So let's go to the code here. I'll briefly explain what I did. So firstly, I've installed the required libraries and everything like OpenCV. Now, the second thing which I'm doing is loading my dataset to this Python code. So as I said, I have taken cricket, basketball, and rugby along with football. So what I'm doing here is, I'm loading the data set and converting into grayscale. After converting into grayscale, what I'm doing is I'm resizing it here, as you can see. I'm resizing it and flattening it. By doing this, what will happen is the image which you are taking will be get converted into an array. So by this code, the image is getting converted to an array. And here, as you can see, I've defined an empty list called input one. So I'm loading that array into this empty list. Similarly for basketball, similarly for rugby, and similarly for football. So now in this input one list, I'll have all the arrays of different balls. So here in the fin input, you can see it here. What I'm doing here is the input one list, I'm converting into an array. Okay. So with this array, we have got the data set completely. So the next step here is, I'm just predicting the size here because I just want to know the dimensions, how my data set is. Now we have our input. We need output for it. So what I'm doing here is I am associating outputs to the given input files. That's what I've done here. I've taken a small data set that is 10 images of each football or basketball or cricket. As my data set is small, I may have a small accuracy, so please bear with me because I'm just explaining the code and how it works. So I'm associating my output to my input file and creating a complete feature here. So this is what I'm doing to create my output. And then I'm converting that output list also into an array, because everything you want to do in machine learning, you need an array. So up till now, we have completed our pre-processing part. So now we have two arrays. One is our output array and one is our input array. In input array, we have loaded all the arrays of cricket, football, basketball, and rugby. Now we'll use this array and split it into testing and training data sets. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm importing sklearn package and splitting my data set into test set and a training set. Make sure that your training set is 60 to 70% of your whole data set, and the rest of your 40% or 30% should be your test or testing set. So let's go to each and every model now. So firstly, let's go to perceptron. So this is a code for perceptron algorithm. So what it does is it trains my data set and create a perceptron algorithm. So I've trained my perceptron algorithm here, and I'm testing the accuracy of it. So as you can see, the accuracy is 0.38. The reason for this low accuracy is, as I said, I took a very small data set that is 10 images of each type of ball. So that's the reason why I'm getting a low accuracy model here. So this is my perceptron. The next thing which I did is the decision tree part. So this is my decision tree. So what I'm doing here is I'm creating a classifier of decision tree and fitting my test and training set and training the model, and I'm storing it in ypredict. Now what I'm doing is I'm trying to predict the accuracy of the ytest and ypredict here. So decision tree accuracy is even pretty low than perceptron, which is 0.25. So this is my decision tree classifier. So the next classification model is a logistic regression model, which is also used, which is also a very good model for classification of different objects. So this is my logistic regression model. So I've imported few libraries here which are required to implement the logistic regression model. So I'm training and training my model with the required data set here in this part. So So these are few warnings which it will automatically take care of the Azure notebook. It just tell us you can do it in a better way. So that's what this warning shows. So now I'm testing it on my testing set and then trying to print my accuracy of the model, which is 0.375, which is a bit close to our perceptron model. And the last but one thing here is the neural networks model. So for neural networks, I'm importing Keras here because it's very much required because we have many neurons here. We have, for the activation function, I'm using ReLU along with the sigmoid activation function. So as you can see here, this is my dimension, which I'm putting it here of my input array, as I discussed earlier. So this will train all my neural networks model in epochs. So it's showing accuracy of 75%, which is pretty higher than the perceptron model, logistic regression, and also the decision tree model, because in neural networks, you take a collective input of many neurons, so you'll get a higher accuracy and you'll get a, because your model is trained well. And so this is my neural networks, which I developed in brief. And finally, the random forest. So this is my random forest code. I'm importing the required libraries for random forest and printing the accuracy. The accuracy is similarly less as compared to neural networks, because neural networks is the best solution which we got. So this is my whole code, which I explained to you in brief. For more detailed explanation, I've also written a blog on this in towards the data science blog here. So I've written my blog in towards data science. So this is my blog. So I've clearly described everything which I explained to you in the video in a more clearer way. So you can have a look of this. I'll also provide the link of this blog in the description. You can get the code and make it run in a good way. So the same thing which I explained to you is here. So hope you enjoyed it and you learned something. Thank you.